Hello and welcome to TalentSprint for a video edition on the banking operations. First, we start by understanding what is a bank. A bank is a financial institution. That's the basic definition of a bank. Bank is an intermediary between the depositors and the borrowers. You've got two categories of customers who are the main categories of customers in banks, and one is the depositor and the other is the borrower. A bank is an intermediary between the depositor and the borrower. A bank is regulated by Reserve Bank of India, which is a monetary authority. The Reserve Bank of India is the central bank of the country, and it regulates all the banks operating in the country. Section 5 of the Banking Regulation Act defines what is banking. According to Section 5 of the Banking Regulation Act, banking means the acceptance for the purpose of lending or investment or otherwise of deposits of money from the public, repayable on demand or otherwise, and withdrawable by cash, draft, order, or otherwise. So Section 5B of the Banking Regulation Act defines banking. Banking means acceptance for the purpose of lending or investment. That is the catchword here. That is, banks accept money from the public for the purpose of lending or investment. The most of the time, the bank accepts deposits for lending. Sometimes they do accept money from deposits for investment. So banks have to accept money for the purpose of lending or investment or otherwise of deposits of money from the public. This is another catchword here, of deposits of money from the public, which means that all banks are supposed to accept deposits from the public. They accept deposits from the public and they are repayable on demand or otherwise. Why would we say on demand or otherwise? This clause otherwise is added here because some deposits are repayable on demand, some are repayable after the maturity of a certain period. That is why this clause repayable on demand or otherwise is added. Repayable on demand are those accounts which are repayable on demand. That is, for example, the savings bank account and the current accounts. And the otherwise is the deposits which are repayable on the maturity of a certain period of time. They are called term deposits. And it's not all. Bank accepts money from the public for the purpose of lending or investment. They accept deposits from the public. They are repayable on demand or otherwise, and more importantly, they are also withdrawable by check, draft, order, or otherwise. They are withdrawable by check, draft, order, or otherwise. We have seen in banks how banks, you can go and withdraw money from a bank using your checkbook. You can take a demand draft for sending money from one city to another. Or you can take a banker's check for payment of money within the same city, or otherwise also you can transfer money. So that means the bank has basically two major functions. One is the acceptance of deposits and second is the lending of loans. And how these deposits are accepted, either they are repayable on demand or they are repayable after the expiry of a certain period, or the money may not be entirely repaid by the bank to the customer, but the customer can withdraw it in installments as and when he needs the money. And the withdrawal can be in the form of by check, by demand draft, by banker's check, that's called the order, or otherwise. That is called the banking as defined under Section 5B of the Banking Regulation Act. So this is a basic introduction to banking. What a bank is, what the bank does, and what is banking as section as what is banking as defined by Section 5B of the Banking Regulation Act of 1949. When we talk of 1949, the year may appear to be very dated. We are in 2017. The Banking Regulation Act was passed in the year 1949. That's almost 68 years back. But the provisions of the Banking Regulation Act of 1949 are valid even till today. And that is why the Banking Regulation Act of 1949, of course, has amended from time to time, depending on the needs of the situation. The RBI has amended, the Government of India and the RBI together have amended the Banking Regulation Act of 1949. But the original act has got a lot of meaning even till this day as far as banking is concerned. So I just introduce you to the concept of banking so that we can understand banking operations better. In the coming videos, we shall talk about various aspects connected to banking, various aspects connected to the day-to-day running of banks. We shall also talk about the various types of accounts in the banks, various types of deposit accounts, the various types of loan accounts, the various types of facilities which are there in the bank, the various types of recent developments like the electronic banking and the automated teller machines. We shall also talk of the banking committees which have been established in the country from the year 1960 onwards. Various committees have been established. All those matters will follow. But this video was just an introduction to the banking operations and what it means. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Till I meet you again in the next video, it's bye from me for now. I'll see you again in a later video. Thanks for watching. Bye.